Hello everybody, my name is Anna Dixon and today we will talk about permanent makeup of eyeliners. And I just want to share by my tips with my experience how to do the eyeliners with the most effective way. And please, if you have a question, you can ask me today, and I would love to share with you my knowledge about eyeliners. So, when you're working with eyeliners, first and the most important to do it as soon as possible. So, we are really trying to do the eyeliners super quick, and this is very, very important because I don't know if you have experienced with eyeliners, but I did it for myself, and this is not spa. Definitely, it's not really comfortable procedure. It's not supposed to be painful, but definitely it's not something what you can really enjoy. And after two passes, it's getting even worse. So the idea to do the eyeliner super quick. So normally if you do the classic eyeliner, I mean if you do like little tail or just between lashes space, it takes 15 minutes. So you need to do the procedure by maximum two passes. And 80-90% of color supposed to be done by first pass. So this is the main trick. We need to implant maximum color by the first pass. How to do it? First, always remember, it's no matter what you work, eyeliners, eyebrows or lips, the first pass is the most effective because when we did not open the skin yet, skin is dry and the needle is not sliding on the surface of the skin. And by this case, you can implant the maximum color into the skin. And what the idea? By the first pass, we are working step by step, like super, super slow. It's like we are doing many, many movements. If you start in a corner, outer corner of the eye, and we are working like 7 minutes. Can you imagine like how many movements you need to do? The working from the outer corner to the inner corner of the eye, it's 7 minutes each. 7 minutes this, 7 minutes this. So it's like very, very short movements. It can be also slow movements. So it's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And movements are super short. It's like half of millimeter. It's almost like a dots technique. And it's like many, 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 many passes. Not like just beginners, they are often doing this mistake when they want to fix the shape like super quick, and they think that they'll just open the skin and then add numbing, then clients will feel much more comfortable and then we will implant more color. No, because when we just open the skin like tick 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 tick, like super super quick, because we are afraid to hurt our clients. And by this case, we open the skin and the swelling is coming. So our skin gets some pressure inside. And by this pressure, it's like on the surface of the skin and pressure inside the skin. So you are trying to implant pigment into the skin. And pressures push everything what you're trying to implant in, that push it out. So it's not really effective. And second, when you already add the numbing of the on the surface of the skin for open skin, our skin changes structure. It's getting so slippery, sliding slow. Needle is like jumping on the surface of the skin and not working so effective. So one more time, for make the first pass of our liner the most effective, we need to do like many, 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 many movements, like step by step, slowly movements, boom, 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 and like many, 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 many short movements, slow movements, and many of them. It takes 5, 7 minutes for just one eyelid. By this case, you will get a very dense color, and you will get a lot of color by the first pass. And when you have a lot of color by the first pass, second pass is like much more effective, because when we already have pigment into the skin, next layer of the skin of the pigments getting much easier. So next trick, how to get very intensive color. It's pigment, it depends on the pigment, and in my many years of experience, and it's just my opinion, I'm not like promoting anything, but I've tried many type of pigments, and in my opinion, the most useful is pigment with carbon black. I know that pigment with carbon black, they're getting bluish and grayish after time, but it's very important to choose the right candidate with the right design of the eyeliner. So I mostly work in between lashes, and between lashes, no matter what skin type your client has, bluish and grayish not like really visible. So I think it's really reasonable to use the most intensive color. So it's very important to get intensive color, even it will be grayish a little bit after time. So I mostly use carbon black tattoo inks. My favorite is Mom or Eternal or Fantasia. Like very tiny size of molecules, and gives you very intensive color. And also tattoo inks is super easy to implant into the skin. It's like I've tried minerals pigment, different brands, but mineral pigments, iron oxide based pigments, usually they include lots of glycerin, and this makes pigments like thick, with a thick consistency. And usually I like it for eyebrows, for example, but for eyeliners, watering consistency is really important, and works much more effective. I think it depends of the skin structure, because skin of eyelids is it's impossible to stretch it properly, like for eyebrows, and for the needle it's difficult to puncture it so effective compare eyebrows. So I think that tattoo inks work super good for eyelids, because of the tattoo inks going into the skin so simple. And when you already implant a lot of pigment into the skin, it's much more effective. So I've tried many different, and for myself, I don't know, maybe for you it will be different, but for myself, I decided that tattoo inks is the most effective way to work for eyeliners. Next trick, I fix the tail when you're doing the wings. So classic eyeliner with longer tail, or it's eyeshadow technique, for example, and you have a design going far from the eye, I fix the shape without numbing. So I fix the shape first, then I add numbing, because here it's really important to do it properly, especially with classic eyeliner. When it's supposed to be super symmetric, and when you do the design and then you apply numbing on top of this, and you are trying to choose markers or gel pen or something, so it will not be spread under the numbing cream. Usually it's spread a little bit, or it's smudged it accidentally. So all your work with design just waste your time, and you need to do all over again. So for myself, I decide, so I do the perfect design, and during it's like perfectly done, not smudged, I just fix it. It's a little bit painful, and your clients can feel uncomfortable about it, but You need to explain this, like, you know, honey, you want a perfectly done eyeliners, and it's very important because this design will stay with you for many years. So come on, this is worth it. I just need 5 seconds because it's like just one pass. It's like 1, 2, 3, done. Another 1, 2, 3, done. So it's super quick, maybe painful, but your design will be fixed and not smashed, and you will not be feeling confused. So for tail, I'm working without numbing. And then when it's this line, like bottom line, is fixed already, it's not a big deal. You just put apply the numbing on top, and feeling very comfortable during the procedure because tail is fixed already, and you are not worried that you will lose the design during your work. Now about technique. And there are two ways for working with eyeliner. It's a single needle technique and group needle technique. With single needle technique, it means that you are working with acupuncture needle, like single needle, but acupuncture needle. Why not classic needle, just long taper? Because long taper is super sharp, and I don't know, I've tried many times, but in my taste it's not reasonable, because acupuncture needle has a bullet shape and it's softer, so it's not puncture the skin so bad, and it's not scratching the skin so bad. Acupuncture is more useful, but even acupuncture needle not match to every type of client. Sometimes especially with the old ladies, the eyelid is super sensitive, so it's so, skin is so thin, and single needle going into the skin so easy, and it's very difficult to control the depth, and it's only one way to control the depth when you're working with not 90 degree, but like with a big angle like this. It's almost like this way. This helps, but in my opinion it's not like really reasonable. So in my practice, and when I'm working with so I can fix the shape by single needle, of course, because tail is always about single needle for make it super sharp, super perfectly done, clear, and no smudged effect. It's always about single needle. But inside, I'm working with a group needle, and my favorite needle is a 3-round liner, because 3-round liner gives you the most intensive, dense color compare all other needle types. And after healing, it gives you the maximum deep, rich color. So 3-round liner is my best friend for work with eyeliners, permanent makeup of eyeliners. But when I'm working with shading, like soft powder, when we are doing the shadow, it can be like smudged effect, or it can be wing, or it can be smudged effect of like pencil effect, just it's like we're doing the classic eyeliner and a little bit smudged, like make it a little bit thicker. I'm working with a single needle, of course, because any type of powdering, for me, it's a single needle always. Next trick, so when you're doing the combination of techniques, so you combine the dense technique with soft powdering techniques, like any type of shading, do the dense color first, because dense color in between lashes, everything which close to the lashes, this is the most painful and create more swelling. So it's better to do it this part first. Like I told before, we are started by first pass and trying to implant the maximum color by the first pass. And then we are trying to add some shading, and shading is not like really painful. And as far you are from lashes, it's less pain for clients. So sometimes we are doing the classic eyeliner here, it takes like 15 minutes, and then I'm just doing the wings here, and almost I'm working without any numbing because it's not really painful. So doing the painful part, the most painful part first. What else? For very, very sensitive skin type, when you see that your client has a lot of blood capillaries, I recommend to work with the dots technique first. So you see that your client has a super, super thin skin type. And you are trying to, the most difficult part for work at this part, like straight under the lashes. In between lashes, it's always work super, super easy. And in between lashes, it's always very easy to implant the pigment. But the most difficult part is to work under the lashes. It's like 1-2 millimeter under the lashes, and especially on the outer corner. This is the most difficult part for implant the pigment. And when you work with this part, I recommend to change the angle of the machine. So when we are working with between lashes, it can be 90 degrees, but I usually work with a 45 degree, like keeping my machine like this angle. But when I work in this part under the lashes, I'm changing the angle of the machine like this way, so it's almost I don't know, it's like 0 degrees, it's like very, very close, it's like parallel to the skin, just a little bit angle. And I'm working with like dots technique, so it's like tick, 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 because I want to implant a little bit pigment into the skin for be sure that I have color into the skin. And by this case, if you keep the skin dry, so not like very don't use like very, very wet cotton disc for wiping it. So you like almost dry cotton disc, and then next layer of the pigment will be much easier. Also little trick, and you can learn it this in my online course, it's manual shading. So sometimes it's difficult to control the depths, and it's like you are doing it and it's nothing into the skin, so you're wiping it and it's like nothing. Just switch the needle and take a manual shading, because with manual shading it's much more difficult to control the depths. Problem for eyeliners, why there is no color into the skin. Usually it's not because we are not deep enough. It's like biological, or I did it and I wipe it and it's nothing, it's me, I need to go deeper. No, with eyeliner usually it's the opposite. It's because we are going too deep. And when we change the angle, usually we can start to see the color into the skin. And if it's so difficult by machine and you switch the needle for manual shading, we are working like more surface and every movement is really effective. And with a bigger group needle, with manual, it's supposed to be big, bigger than 8. I love soft top needle, round shape, or it can be like 13, 14, 18. So it's a lot of needle, and by this case, it's easier to control the depths, and we are not going so deep. So it's one more proof that we're supposed to work as surface as possible. This makes your work more effective. So this and many other tricks for my work, I will share my online course which will start, I need to double check, I think 12 December. It will be course about eyeliners and lips together. So please welcome if you are interested to take my online courses and learn by me. I will be happy to see you in the new group. All information you can find on my website. It's dixonpmu.com, dixonpmu.com, and you can enroll for the new online course. So please welcome. I will be happy to make your professional life in permanent makeup a little bit easier. So thank you so much for being with me. Thank you so much for watching. You can ask question under this video. I will read your comments and trying to answer. And see you soon in the new live video with me. My name is Anna Dixon, and thank you again for watching. Have a nice day.